Welcome everyone to another Godot related video. I've been pretty busy these past 2 weeks, so I'm going to just do a quick update video of the latest changes we've done. In this video, I will be giving a demo of our leap motion driver. After that, I will give a quick demonstration on some new functionality I've been working on in VR, including collision detection for the teleport and direct movement function. As always, links to everything will be in the description below. So first, onto leap motion. I've had a lot of fun with my little leap motion device. Initially, I was a little disappointed because some of the free demos that you get when you first install it didn't give me some problems. It seems to be in part because these demos are fairly old, as I have not had any problems working with the leap motion directly. If you want to give the drivers a try, you'll need to compile them from source. For this, you will need to download the new Orion Beta SDK, as we will be using the new leap seed libraries. There is only support for Windows at this point in time. Linux and Mac support will eventually be added as well. There is some great documentation on leap motion's website. I have to admit that I found the leap seed libraries a joy to work with. They are very easy to understand. One thing that I thought was very funny was leap motion pointing out that they were emitting the wrong bone in the thumb. Be aware that we also use the naming as is given in the SDK. Finally, you will need to download or clone the GDLeapMotion repository on my GitHub page. Instructions about compiling this can be found in the README document. I've created a very simple scene in Godot. Nothing fancy, just functional. I will create a nicer looking demo later on, once the driver is complete. There are a few cylinder shaped objects in our scene, with a matching collider shape. These are all rigid bodies, so we can interact with them. I also created a tray with a few box shapes that has static colliders. Originally I had a flat plane, but my cylinders kept rolling away. As you can see, there is no object in our scene or our tree that represents our leap motion device. All I have is a little sphere at the origin point, which I added purely as a guide. As with other GD native plugins, the leap motion device is added in through code. This code is fairly straightforward. We instantiate a new leap motion device by loading our GDNS file. Then we load a scene for our left hand and right hand and provide these scenes to the leap motion driver. The driver will add instances of these scenes as it starts tracking hands, and yes, it can track more than two hands. Finally, we add our leap motion node as a child node to our scene. The scenes that we use for the hands can be found in the leap motion subfolder. The left hand scene and right hand scene are basically the same, they just mirror each other. We have a sphere mesh as the origin point of our hand. Then each finger is created from a set of 4 or 5 sphere meshes that denote the joints. And then we use a couple of cylinder meshes for the bones. Now this is just a sample scene, you can create your own scene for the hands. The only part that the driver requires is that you have the nodes for the joints of the fingers named as they are named in this scene. The driver will update the position and rotation of these joints as the device tracks the fingers. The bones, however, are updated within the script on our root node. All the script does is change the size and offset of our bones to match the distance between our joints. The bone is automatically repositioned as the joints are rotated by our driver. Let's run our little project and see how it works. I wanted to use my webcam so you could see my hands moving, however OBS didn't want to play along. The tracking of the position of the hands is spot on. Tracking the finger positions is pretty solid as well, but once in a while a finger gets obscured from view and leap motion makes small mistakes. That notwithstanding, I am incredibly impressed by how well this is working. The physics simulation is really simplistic at the moment, so while I can lift the cans out of the tray and push them around, grabbing is hit and miss at the moment. Leap motion can detect certain gestures, and I will expose that logic in due time, so you can solve grabbing items in code. That will be cheaper than having the physics engine handle everything. There are other issues to solve. I can, for instance, push the cans through the bottom of the tray. I couldn't resist having a quick try in VR as well. Bear in mind that there are still a lot of things that need to change. The biggest issue that needs to be solved is when you move your head. As the tracking leap motion does is independent of the tracking of your headset, there is a timing issue. You'll see that the hands start to drift, and that will be my next task. You can't really get this sensation from a YouTube video, but the feeling of hand presence is really something. I can fully understand the appeal. This is running on my Oculus Rift. There is a brightness issue I still need to fix, but other than that, I'm very happy how this is going so far. I really can't get enough just playing around. I'm not sure yet what sort of demo I should create with this that would really show it off. If you have any suggestions, please leave a comment. That's enough about the leap motion. Let's have a look at the enhanced teleport and direct movement logic. You can find a new project on my GitHub page called VR Demo. This is a continuation of the project we created in my earlier OpenVR tutorial. I will do a proper video at a later date where I will take a closer look at the code. I want to improve a few things in the demo first. You can see that instead of controllers, I now show two meshes of hands. I only dropped those in yesterday, so they need more work. This has allowed me to change the project so it doesn't use anything specific to any platform, and the demo will run on both OpenVR and Oculus. I have also moved a few files that are shared between these assets into a folder called Add-on VR Common. I have made the same change on the assets in the asset library, however, this project contains slightly newer logic. Once I put the final touches in the logic, the assets will be updated. Just as with the old implementation, the right controller is used for direct motion by using the thumb pad on the Vive wand or the analog joystick on the touch controller. You can see that the character now properly interacts with objects in the scene. The left controller is used as a teleporter and works using the trigger. You can see that our aiming reticle changes from blue, which means that you are aiming too far, red, which means you're hitting a wall, or green, which means you can teleport there. Release the trigger and you teleport. I have also added a transparent capsule to show the size of the player. That's all I have time for today. Thanks for watching, until next time.